Good morning, students. This is Mr. Milind S. Shinde, Assistant Professor in English at GS College of Commerce, Kolkata. Today, we are going to discuss the story The Portrait of a Lady by Khushwant Singh. As the title itself tells us that this story is about two persons. First of all, portrait, and second, lady. Because these two are very important words so far as the story is concerned. Because this story is about the portrait or an image or a picture of a lady. Now, it is not just about the image. Actually, it is about the lady, a woman. Now, who is this woman? It is very important for us to know as we are going to discuss this story. So, the lady or the woman who is shown in the story is grandmother of Khushwant Singh. Khushwant Singh is presented as the narrator of the story also. Now see, the story begins in a village. As all of us are well familiar with the village life, the people living in villages or the rural areas or the rustic areas are always happy. It's because their needs are always limited. Now see, Khushwant Singh is shown just as a child. And the caretaker who is there to look after him is his grandma. Both are living happily, they are always happy. And as Khushwant Singh is just a child, it is the duty of his grandmother to make him ready, to take him to school. Now, when we speak about school in that village, it is also very small. It is not anywhere big, it is not anywhere huge. It's not a big building. And that's why Khushwant Singh's grandma always takes care of her grandchild or grandson, that is Khushwant Singh there. She gets him bath, she gets him ready for school, and whenever she takes him to school, which is just adjacent to the village temple, that time she always takes with herself two or three stale chapatis. Now, a point will come into your mind that why stale chapatis? Now, stale chapatis are not for her grandson, that is Khushwant Singh, but for the street dogs. It shows us that she has love in her heart for human beings, of course for human beings. Apart from human beings, she has love and kindness in her heart for the animals also. Now, this is just the routine of Khushwant Singh and his grandmother's life. Daily they get ready, daily they come to school. And as I just have told you that the school is adjacent to the temple, Khushwant Singh of course sits in the school and his grandmother goes into the temple. She prays there, she is there until Khushwant Singh's classes are over. And after the classes are over, both of them come back to their home. While coming back to home, she throws the crumbs of those chapatis or breads to the street dogs. So this is the routine of Khushwant Singh and his grandma who are living in the village. Now really they are enjoying their life, they are happy. But one turn comes in their life. It is, we can call it a paradigm shift, because it is a big change in their life. Why I am saying this? You would come to know in the later episode of this story. Now see, what change occurs in their life. After some years, when Khushwant Singh's parents get well settled in city, they call Khushwant Singh as well as his grandma to city. And now, here the environment is quite different. Here the atmosphere is quite different. Now Khushwant Singh's grandma, she has one habit when she is in the village, and the habit is of feeding the stray dogs, or stray dogs we can say here, stray dogs. But in city, there are no dogs. The houses are so big. Temples are there, but they are not close to their residence. They are far away, and that's why it becomes very difficult for Khushwant Singh's grandma to go to temple regularly. Secondly, Khushwant Singh is admitted, or the narrator of this story is admitted in English school. Now the environment or the atmosphere of English school is quite different from the school in that village where Khushwant Singh was living for many years along with his grandma. Now, when he get admitted in English medium school or English school, one new thing occurs. What is that new thing? Khushwant Singh is taught music, he is taught dance, mathematics, science. All these subjects are just just beyond the understanding of his grandma, that is lady. And that's why she is literally helpless. She is literally helpless in helping Khushwant Singh in his studies. Now one day what happens? Khushwant Singh comes back home from the school and he is very happy. His grandma asks him what is the matter, and he tells that they were taught the lessons about music and dance. When Khushwant Singh's grandma hears about this, she becomes disappointed, because for her dance and music have somewhere lewd association. These things does not have prestige in the civil society according to her, but this is the city life, it is quite different, and it doesn't have that kind of association which Khushwant Singh's grandma tells her grandson, that is Khushwant Singh. Of course, out of compulsion, as it is the part of syllabus, Khushwant Singh has to learn all those things in the school. She has another complaint. What is that complaint? The complaint is about why the scriptures and the information about God is not given, or these things are not taught in the English schools. And that is why she is disappointed. Now, but she cannot do anything because it is the part of their syllabus. Even though these differences are there, both of them are happy, and now Khushwant Singh starts going to college. Now Khushwant Singh is provided separate room. It becomes somewhat hard or difficult for his grandma to meet Khushwant Singh all the time, because he is always in his room studying. And secondly, as I have told you, that the subjects which are taught in that school, English medium school or English school, are quite different, about which his grandmother doesn't know anything. After some years, what happens? Khushwant Singh decides to go abroad. He wants to go abroad really for 5 years for his higher studies. It means his grandma has to be away from him nearly for 5 years. Now see, when Khushwant Singh starts his journey, means when he goes to railway station and his grandma also goes there to see off her grandson, she is very moderate in her behavior. She does not show the emotions on her face. And she just again praying to God, because she is always busy with her prayers. After 5 years, he comes back. Again, Khushwant Singh goes there. Khushwant Singh's grandma goes to the restaurant to receive him. Both of them come to home. Now see, as in the beginning I told that Khushwant Singh's grandma had one habit in the village to feed, to throw the crumbs of bread at the stray dogs. This is, you know, somewhat the change that occurs in her life when she comes to live in the city. Because in city she doesn't have stray dogs. Instead of that, she does one another thing. She develops one another habit, that is feeding the sparrows. And she somehow manages to live there by, you know, throwing crumbs of bread at the sparrows. And secondly, she is always on the spinning wheel. So whenever she is there spinning the wheel, that time so many sparrows come there and she throws the crumbs of bread at them. After some years, one day what happens? She starts beating the drum. She calls all the women from the neighborhood. Nobody knows what has happened to that lady. All ladies come there and she's just singing, screaming, she's speaking loudly. And the next morning, she falls ill. The doctor comes. he tells the member of family that she just ill and should recover soon. But the next evening, she dies. Now see, we have seen here the journey of Kushan Singh's grandma. When she was living in the village and her death in the city. After her death, one thing happens. It is quite surprising to everybody because so many sparrows come there. Now their master, their beloved person is not there, and that's why, seeing that scenario, Kushwant Singh's mother throws the crumbs of bread or the chapatis at those sparrows, but the sparrows do not touch those crumbs, as if they are just come there to take the last instruction of the deceased soul, that is Kushwant Singh's grandmother. And at the end, without touching those crumbs, all the sparrows flee away or go away from that spot. So in a nutshell, what does we learn from this story? That is, Kushwant Singh's grandma was really a benevolent lady, was really a kind lady, was really a beloved lady. And this shows us the relationship of Kushwant Singh grandma with human beings as well as animals and birds around. Thank you.